This is a 1976 Rolls-Royce Camargue. We've a Jaggard board, spent a lot of time on this car. We've done quite a lot of work to the car, as in hydraulic wise, suspension wise, generally tightening the car up. It's now drives an absolutely fantastic. Gear changes are lovely, brakes are lovely, suspension's lovely. So it's quite a lovely place to be. I know that Camargue is not everybody's cup of tea, but to me they are fantastic cars. They've got superb sort of interior, which is pretty unique to the Camargue. And the running gear has got very much similarities to Corniche by name, where it has quite a lot of chalotier components on it. But you know, they are what I described as a Marmite car, but they are good fun to drive. And my God, do you get some looks in such a car? So especially as it's got a gold spirit, but ecstasy on the rim as well, just to put a point on it. But this is Carl's probably his second time out on the road, so it's a bit of a shakedown, finding suspension knobs. As you probably noticed, the speedo drives a little bit noisy, got to be sorted out. One of the next steps on the car is that it's going to have a new AC compressor, as that's quite noisy when it cuts in. But that would obviously have to be changed to 134A because it's still on R12 gas, and obviously it's going to have a conversion as well. This is generally what happens when you have a shakedown with these cars. If they've been sitting around for a long time, that can unearth all kinds of faults. So, which is a good thing in some aspects, because you'll get to learn about the car and the various items which sort of need to be sorted out after the car's been driven some distance. But in some other aspects it's quite nice, is because after working on the car for quite some time, it's quite nice to drive around and actually start to feel or notice the differences you've made to the car after its initial inspection, noticing all the various problems with it. You can basically cure these problems, and suddenly it absolutely transforms the car and it becomes quite an enjoyable place. It's amazing when you know you're looking at a car which is 40 plus years old, and it drives like brand new basically, you know. The gear change is lovely, the diff is sort of quiet. So it's just basically a case of once you work your way around all the various faults that you obviously come across on the initial few road tests, and you can cure these, and then it just puts the icing on the cake basically.
Telling me I got to beware.
Silex carburetor on here. I mean, people talk about converting to SUs, but it's a really good carburetor. I mean, so I'm sort of just starting to really learn again about it, really, because it's lovely progressive power on the body. So you sort of loathe to remove it and sort of do the conversion, you know, when it actually is, it drives okay.
This headline's being wrong. Nobody's right if everybody's wrong. Young people speak in their minds. I'm getting so much resistance from behind. Time we stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going on.
That's 70 there. Nice and stable. Place to be, really, isn't it? Testament to the new owner, because he's been quite willing to invest in this car. He knows that it's going to take time, effort, but he's what we call as a car man. He understands that you come across certain issues along the way with these cars. They're never going to. These kinds of cars, you are working, you do work through the problems, and there is a pinnacle point when then you have cured everything, but but there's always something next, isn't there? It is down to the owners and their love and passion for these cars that keeps these cars alive, you know. I mean, they could just disappear into the abyss, but the owners sort of see the potential in them as also out of enjoyment and as a financial thing as well for the future. But it is quite quite a thing to invest in these cars, because they're not the cheapest on parts, and then they're not the cheapest on labour times. But it's the thing is, though, you're sort of paying for these quality items which have to be manufactured, and also the fact is that you're paying for the knowledge that goes along with rebuilding these cars and knowing what needs to go where and what settings have to be right. And you know, I'm very one for as many people probably know me quite well about standing heights. I'm absolutely fanatical about standing heights on these cars, but
what's going on?